Hi, this is USDJ PY, and today it's Monday, 2nd of September 2013, and the time is 8:16 GMT. We are looking at the H4 time frame of the pair, and we just had a very strong bullish Kumo breakout, a very strong bullish breakout, and this breakout even broke the upper trend line of a strong consolidation triangle, which we can see better on the daily time frame of the pair. So the big bullish move is yet to happen, as we see on the daily time frame, where the Kumo is still in horizontal position, and we expect this move to be strong enough to give a similar picture to this on the daily time frame as well. Let's have a bigger picture first before we go down to the smallest time frame, which is M1, from which we are going to pick our entry point. So everything looks bullish for now, although Chikuspan, the green line, has not gone above past price action yet. Price has not broken through the Kumo yet, but things look bullish on daily time frame. Strongly bullish on weekly time frame, although it had those big corrective waves for weeks. But now it seems that it's time for the pair to fly, okay, to continue its flight. And let's look at the monthly time frame, and most possibly September may be the month of the bullish Kumo breakout on the monthly time frame for the pair. See how sharp pointing upwards the newborn bullish Kumo here is. How this is the leading Kumo, it is bullish and its edge is sharp pointing upwards. So all this dynamic energy accumulated in the pair for all this time where it was fighting against the Kumo resistance is going to be released into a boom, an explosive bullish Kumo breakout. And maybe this will happen successfully during September. We'll see. So back to the smaller time frames. 8-4. We will be monitoring our trade from 8-4. And once we enter, we will put our stop loss 150-160 pips below our entry, just below the lower border of the Kumo here, of this Kumo, the flat top Kumo. But we must go down to M1 and pick our entry from M1 only if all our entry criteria are met. And our entry criteria are that all time frames must be 100% bullish before we enter all smaller time frames than H4. So we start with H1 and let's look at it and see if it is 100% bullish. Yes, it's 100% bullish. Look at the straight upward, almost vertical slope of the leading Kumo. Look how sharp it is at the edge, although we had this bearish candlestick. This is a minor correction, okay? We don't enter, of course, because we see Chikuspan going down for now, so we wait. Look at the breakout, at its strength. We see Chikuspan is above past price action, going straight up. We see it goes above the Kumo as well. We see that price is above Tenkan-sen, and Kijun-sen, the two lines are sloping upwards. Everything is bullish here. M30, strong bullish breakout as we look at it from M30 time frame, although Chikuspan is turned downwards for now because we have this correction, so we wait. you always pay attention to the angles. When you see this vertical vertical position of the kumo, of the leading kumo, be sure that this is a breakout. But be careful, you don't want to miss the pips, so don't enter during this correction. Enter when the correction is over and when the pair resumes its uptrend. This is some profit taking from investors who are long, and they caught the move, and they are now cashing out some of their pips or their profits, and they will enter long again to push the price higher. That's the point, the time point where you want to join them. Okay, so we are on M15. Everything looks bullish except Chiku Span, which we want to go straight upwards before we enter. So we go to M5. Everything looks bullish, and we see here that Chiku Span is just an upwards, so it's a nice point to enter, but we want to confirm it from M1. And M1 says that Chiku Span is not above the past price action yet. We don't have a bullish Kumo breakout here yet, because price dived inside the Kumo and now it's going to go out. So we better enter when we see clearly price going above the Kumo and Chiku Span going above past price action. It's not an issue if we miss a few pips, this distance here. It's not a problem. It's better that we make sure that we enter when everything is clearly and totally bullish. Now, back to H4, where we'll be monitoring our trade from. We put our stop loss, and we expect, since we enter after a bullish Kumo breakout on H4 time frame with a vertical leading Kumo, we expect that this is going to be a long uptrend. So we expect our take profit target to be at a bearish Kumo breakout, when price goes up, and then turns downwards, passing from the other side of the Kumo and giving a bearish Kumo breakout on this time frame, on H4 time frame. Till then, you will have the chance to make a lot of profits. Of course, you can exit using my trade cutting off system, and when you see that one of your strong bullish candlesticks on H4 starts turning bearish, only if you are having profits already and you want to keep your profits, you switch to M15, and when you see the price going below Tenkan Sen on M15, the thing that you see here on H4, when you see this on M15, you are out. So I'm zooming in. You enter on H4, you monitor your trade from H4, and when you see your bullish candlestick on H4, which is already giving you profits, when you see that something bearish is going on there, you switch to M15, and for instance, it was going up, but when you see it going down from M15, below Tenkan Sen, you exit, and you wait on M15 to see it going above Tenkan Sen, the red line, to enter long again. Pretty clear. So this is it. Thanks for watching, and happy pips.